Speed control methods of a DC motor can be varied by varying flux, armature resistance, or applied voltage. Different speed control methods for different DC shunt and series methods are there. We also know DC motor is an electrical machine that converts direct current electrical energy into mechanical energy. When the current carrying armature is connected to the supply end through commutator segment, brushes are placed within the north-south poles of permanent or electromagnets. By using this electromagnet's operating principle, it depends on the Fleming left-hand rule to determine the direction of the force acting on the armature conductors of the DC motor. In this video, we will go to learn different speed control methods of DC motor. Speed of DC shunt motor is controlled method by the stated below. 1. Flux control method. 2. Armature and rheostatic control method. 3. Voltage control method. Voltage control method are two types. A. Multiple voltage control. B. Ward-Leonard system. Flux control method. In this method, speed of a DC motor is inversely proportional to the flux per pole. Thus, by decreasing flux and speed can be increased vice versa. To control the flux, his rheostatic is added in series with the field winding will increase the speed. Because of this, flux will decrease. So the field current is relatively small and hence copper loss is decreased. This method is quite efficient. Armature and rheostatic control method. Speed of a DC motor is directly proportional to the back EMF. That means when the supply voltage V and the armature resistance RA are kept constant, speed is directly proportional to the armature current IA. Thus, if we add a resistance in series with the armature, IA decreases and hence the speed also decreases. Greater the resistance in series with the armature, greater the decrease in speed. Multiple voltage control. In this method, the shunt field is connected to a fixed exciting voltage and armature is supplied with different voltages. Voltage across armature is changed with the help of suitable switchgear. The speed is approximately proportional to the voltage across the armature. Ward-Leonard system. This Ward-Leonard system is used where very sensitive speed control of the motor is required. For example, electric excavators, elevators, etc. The arrangement of this system is as required in this figure. In this method, the output from the generator Z is fed to armature of the motor M2 whose speed is to be controlled. The output voltage of the generator Z can be varied from 0 to its maximum value by means of its field regulator and hence the armature voltage of the motor M2 is varied very smoothly. Hence, very smooth speed control of the DC motor can be obtained by this method. Speed of DC series motor is controlled methods by the stated below. A. Flux control method. Flux control methods are four types. 1. Field diverter. 2. Armature diverter. 3. Tapped field control. 4. Paralleling field coils. B. Variable resistance in series with armature. C. Series parallel control method. Field diverter. A variable resistance is connected parallel to the series field. This variable resistor is called as diverter, as the desired amount of current can be diverted through the resistance and hence current through field coil can be decreased. Hence, flux can be decreased to the desired amount and speed can be increased. Armature diverter. Diverter or rheostat is connected across the armature for a given constant load torque. If armature current is reduced, then flux must increase. This will result in an increase in current taken from the supply and hence flux will increase and subsequently speed of the motor will decrease. Tapped field control. As shown in figure, the field coil is tapped divided number of turns. Thus, we can select different value of flux by selecting different number of turns. Paralleling field coils. In this method, several speeds can be obtained regrouping coil as shown figure is below. variable resistance in series with armature. By introducing a resistance A series with the armature, voltage across the armature can be reduced, and hence speed reducing in proportion with it. Series parallel control. This system is widely used in electric traction, where two or more mechanically coupled series motors are employed. For low speed, the motor are connected in series, and for higher speed, the motor are connected in parallel. When in series, the motor have a same current passing through them, although voltage across each motor is divided. When in parallel, the voltage across each motor is same, although the current gets divided. Dear viewers, thanks for watching the video. Any question, write the comment box. Don't forget to like and share. More update, please subscribe our channel Learning Engineering and get notification to press the bell icon.